We've been broadcasters for more than 20 years, and now we own Insightful Media, putting our experience to use for you.
Video content is more important than ever, and we can do it for you. Whether it's telling your company's story, client testimonials, or social media spots, we'll do it.
And if you need an on-camera or event host, even a spokesperson, we'll do that too. And we share our decades of experience to media train so that you look professional and polished.
Find us online at the address on your screen or search Insightful Media.
Business, law, and politics is really the core of what we are. People here have a really good business sense. They like getting involved with clients and helping them solve problems.
Our culture is incredibly strong at Brownstein because of our founders, I think, and it's remained strong because of our leadership group.
We really take our position seriously to improve the community in, you know, every positive way possible.
Ballet Theater's The Nutcracker, home for the holidays. A kid's eye view.
It's a classic story that has become part of our holiday tradition. And now we are bringing The Nutcracker home for the holidays. Thank you for joining us. I'm Dayna Roselli.
And I'm Sean McAllister. We are here at the Ethel M. Chocolates Holiday Cactus Garden, which has really become a timeless tradition here in the Las Vegas community. Every night from November to January, Ethel M. Chocolates' 3-acre cactus garden transforms into a winter wonderland with millions of twinkling lights that really brings the holiday season to life. The Nutcracker is the story of a young girl on Christmas Eve and her awakening to a new world filled with magic. A battle between good and evil, wild characters, and of course, lots of dancing.
Well, the ballet has become the most popular holiday production almost 100 years after it first appeared on stage.
It was during our first episode that we took a trip back in time, revisiting the history of the Nutcracker, both across the country and its rich history right here in Southern Nevada. Then, during our last show, we explored everything from the amazing costumes to those massive set pieces and even some of the iconic choreography.
But there is one area that we haven't explored, and that's the heart of what this show is all about, seeing Christmas through the eyes of a child. The Nutcracker is one for those both young and young at heart.
I think the Nutcracker is so magical because you get to have a Nutcracker family when you're there, and everyone works with each other, the company members with you and the stage crew. And also the props are amazing.
The best part about performing in the Nutcracker is to see the audience and to perform for them.
The feeling that you get when you walk on the stage.
It is just such a magical experience. I mean, I get to dance with all the amazing company members, and they have these nice large sets and beautiful costumes. It's just super fun.
Dancer, it's your very, very first experience working with a professional company on a professional stage with the real costumes and the real scenery. And I think that that's why it's so special for students.
The best part of performing in the Nutcracker is definitely getting to perform with the company members and with my friends. And I also love to perform in the Smith Center stage. It's amazing.
It is so realistic. Like, they have the giant houses, the costumes, and then you have all the amazing dancers. Everything just works together.
We were
work together really hard, and that's what makes us perform really well. It's really like adventurous and fun, but magical and unique, and it's definitely a tradition that you would want to be a part of.
It's so realistic, and it just feels like you're a part of it, and you're going along the journey with Clara.
It's a really nice classical ballet. It feels like a fairy tale.
I'd have to say my favorite memory working with the kids is really opening night. It's a magical experience for them because it's the first time they're on the stage with a full house. They can see the audience, their friends and family are there, and they really get to feel that magic. And they come backstage and they look at me and they're just like, this was so cool.
Nutcracker is like an inspiration for all of us. We would all love to be dancers when we grow up.
The Nutcracker may be full of beautiful dances and timeless music, but there's also room for a little comedy in the form of Mother Ginger.
Well, it's fair to say things are a little bit different seeing this production on screen rather than in real life. Seeing that giant 30-foot Christmas tree and those 15-foot grandfather clocks in person is just amazing.
And that first time seeing the show can have an impact that lasts a lifetime.
Year, dozens of children perform in the Nutcracker, but just as important are the thousands of young people who are treated to a very special Nutcracker experience.
When the school buses pull up and the kids walk out, and as soon as they walk into the Smith Center, I mean, just stars in their eyes and the magic as they look around the lobby and sit down and just the whole experience.
As part of NBT's education and outreach program, students from the Clark County School District, charter, private, and parochial schools are invited to special matinee performances of the Nutcracker, designed to give an inside look at the creative process and the behind-the-scenes work that's needed to bring the show to life.
And one of the things I always love is when it snows. And for some of these kids that were born and raised in Las Vegas, it might be the first time they've seen snow. You can hear them screaming. They bring the house down like you're at a rock concert.
The student matinee series is just one of NBT's many education and outreach programs, which impact over 20,000 students annually.
7, 8, stomp one.
These programs can shape the bodies, minds, and futures of Las Vegas's young people. And for many kids, seeing the Nutcracker through the student matinee series will be their first time watching a professional ballet company at a time of year filled with joy and possibility, sparking a love of dance that will stay with them for a lifetime.
It really kicks you off for an amazing holiday season, and it makes you feel so much joy because the kids are just so excited to be there.
We hope you're enjoying the show. As you can already see, there is so much that goes into making this production come to life. And all of that comes with a hefty price tag, of course. Each year, we ask the people of Las Vegas to help support NBT through charitable contributions that allow us to entertain our audiences, train the next generation of dancers through our academy, and continue to provide opportunities to thousands of Clark County students through our life-changing education and outreach programs. As we approach our 50th anniversary next year, we would once again like to ask you for your support. We hope during this time of holiday spirit and goodwill, you will consider making a tax-deductible donation in any amount to NBT. Your support will help fulfill our mission to ensure artistry, education, and inspiration for all of Las Vegas for the next 50 years and beyond. To learn more about Nevada Ballet Theater and the critical work we do for our community, visit nevadaballet.org. Thank you for your support. And now back to the show.
Picking just one favorite part of the show can be a challenge for a production like this that has it all, including bringing snow to the desert.
It takes a village to make this show come to life, and the Nutcracker wouldn't be here almost 40 years later without the support of some of the generous members of our community.
You think about the Smith Center being a place that was built for those of us who live here. You know, we're the entertainment capital of the world, but the Smith Center is for locals, mostly anyway. And when you think about locals, you think about these traditions, and nothing's better than the Nutcracker. So to open this beautiful new building with a brand new Nutcracker was really special. And of course, we all have to thank Nancy Housels and all those who made it possible.
Smith Center took us about 18 years to be built and to open. And thank goodness for Don Snyder and Myron and all the people who worked on it. It was a labor of love for sure. And we're so happy to be the resident dance company here.
This is all about community. The Nevada Ballet Theater, the Smith Center, doing things that we can do together as community and as a family. What a great, not only a holiday tradition, but what a great tradition for our city. And people talk about the Nutcracker being kind of an over-the-top production, but you think about Las Vegas being the entertainment capital of the world. I mean, there's more Swarovski crystals up and down the strip than, you know, per capita than any other city. I'm not sure that this Nutcracker has to be the most flamboyant production ever made. What I do think is that it has to be really good. And I think the Nevada Ballet Theater has nailed it.
There's so much time, energy, and creativity that goes into making the Nutcracker. And while it's truly a team effort, it is the choreographer who makes this vision come to life. Nevada Ballet Theater's current version, choreographed by James Canfield, debuted in 2012 as part of NBT's first full season at the Smith Center. Since then, it's been captivating audiences and become an annual tradition. But it all started with a young boy who just happened to see the Nutcracker for the very first time.
What I used to say to the dancers is, remember, you may have done this 1,000 times, but there's a little girl or a little boy sitting in that audience, and it's their first time. And they need to be brought into the magic as though it's your first time, and you're speaking just to them. My introduction to ballet was actually through the Nutcracker. When you're involved in a tap class, which I was in Richmond, Virginia, the ballet company at the time goes to those studios around Richmond to recruit young boys to be their party boys in their local production of the Nutcracker. And they, of course, invited guest artists in to do the Sugar Plum Fairy and Cavalier. It just so happened that year it was Edward Villella and Violette Verdi. Seeing him do what he did as a male dancer, and of course how beautiful a ballerina she was, I got intrigued, and that was sort of my motivation to further my interest in ballet. So Nutcracker was the vehicle that drove me to ballet. And that happened in 1970, and there hasn't been a year since that I've been without the Nutcracker.
Over his decades-long career, James has choreographed 5 productions of the Nutcracker, and each time he has included dozens of children in the cast because he knows firsthand how the Nutcracker creates a lifelong bond between young performers and the world of dance.
Once they walk into the theater, any of those kids, they can't believe where they are. I mean, and it reminds me of me, because there was a smell, there was a scale, there was something about it that just was so intriguing to me that I wanted it to be a part of my life, and I knew it. It is a ballet that's about dreams coming true, and you want to make those dreams come true for those kids.
Coming up, the grand finale of our series ends with a curtain call you don't want to miss. Scenes like that which make this show unforgettable. Sean, do you remember the first time you saw the Nutcracker?
I mean, how could I forget? I was mesmerized the first time I saw all those children running out from underneath Mother Ginger's dress. It's still one of my favorite parts of the show to this day. What about you?
Well, I just love when the Christmas tree grows, you know? It's just always so spectacular and fun to see. I've always been in awe of that. And, you know, we aren't the only ones to have such strong reactions from seeing the show.
I would say magical.
Joyful.
Spectacular.
Fun.
Magical.
Christmassy.
Riveting.
Stunning.
Whimsical. Entertaining.
Beautiful.
Spectacular.
There's 2 parts. Can I have 2 favorite parts?
There's just so much. There's so much to pick from.
The totality of the experience. I mean, it's there's so much in it.
When the lights go down and the overture starts, it's magical. To all of a sudden have the theater go dark and to be surrounded by all the people that I love and all my friends in the community.
Walking in and seeing all these young children, and you can see some are there for the very first time and their parents have them all dressed up, and sometimes I'll just watch in the audience to see their reaction.
When I first started seeing Nutcracker, it was all about the dancing and the second act and
you know, the Russian and the Chinese and the Arabian dance. That was always my favorite part. But as time goes on, you know, the music better. And then, of course, having Gabby in it, my favorite part was the party scene. There's so many different things to look at for the party scene and different facial expressions.
I love the very beginning of it. It makes me want to be 5 years old again. It just brings out that childlike energy.
It's just spectacular to have the stage full of the beautiful professional ballet dancers and then the aspiring young kids that are coming up through the ranks. To see that on stage and also around Christmas time, it just makes all the difference.
My favorite part for performing was definitely the party scene where you get to act out the story. But when I watch it, my favorite part is definitely the winter scene where there's the winter fairy and there's all these cool roll-offs and they're all dancing together and it's really pretty.
I think the snow is one of the most magical moments in the show. It starts off with little snowflakes, just like any snowstorm would start. And the dancers go running across the stage and you feel the tension building up. And by the end, there's snow coming down and the dancers are all dancing. It's just a magical time. They're all very well-rounded athletes as well as polished, highly skilled dancers.
The guy can do 10 pirouettes in 10 seconds while I can do a pirouette in about 5.
The dance of the sugar plum fairies, I love that one. It's sparkly and fun and it's happy and joyous. I just love watching.
You know, hearing the same great music year after year when it comes to that, you look forward to it.
The Sugar Plum Fairy and the Snow Fairies, I like that traditional ballet, but I also am a big fan of the Arabian dance.
That peacock is something special.
To me, it's the most exotic. The music is you know, quite a bit different than the balance of the ballet.
And of course, Mother Ginger with the children is always the fun part.
The Mother Ginger part, where all of the kids come out of the skirt and it's really entertaining, where they do the cartwheels and the handstands and the front walkovers, and they're doing all this stuff and it's so clean that when you watch it, it's like, wow, I could never do that. That's very impressive.
My favorite part is the fight scene between the Nutcracker and the Mouse. And the live shows, you really feel the music. You know, you feel the bass and the violins just like flowing through you. It really gets you excited. It really like makes you feel like you're experiencing it and you're a part of the scene.
It's a show that we all can enjoy. It doesn't matter what age you are. It doesn't matter what ethnicity you are, what gender you are. It just has a way of touching you.
I think everything about it is stunning. The production, the set designs, the live orchestra, the costumes.
To me, it hits everything. It's light, it's funny, so it makes you just want to walk out happy and smiling. And who doesn't want to smile during Christmas? It makes you feel loved. It makes you want to fall in love. And who doesn't want to fall in love during the holidays and feel love? It just is perfect.
This has been such a wonderful journey, and we can't thank you enough for allowing us into your homes for this year's first ever look behind the scenes of Nevada Ballet Theater's production of The Nutcracker.
While so many things are different, we are so glad this is one holiday tradition that is able to live on and perhaps give you a chance to make new memories as a family. On behalf of the entire team at Nevada Ballet Theater, the Las Vegas Review-Journal, and all of the performers, staff members, and families that have been a part of our series, we want to thank you for joining us and allowing the Nutcracker to be in your home for the holidays.
And remember, if you want to continue to see this production and many, many more just like it come back to the stage, we hope you'll consider making a donation using that link below. It's so important to keep the arts top of mind. But before we go, you can't have a show without a finale. So please enjoy this special performance from The Nutcracker.